Vocal tuning, Boston's Brad Delp.
Thou shalt not desecrate fine art, Dr. Bob.
Okay, Lord. Okay, Lord. I'll restore the file to its original condition. Next, on Music Surgery with Dr. Bob. Undeniably, one of the greatest rock singers with one of the greatest rock vocal ranges ever, Brad Delp and the music of Boston have been the soundtrack to our lives. It's no secret that the mastermind behind Boston, Tom Scholz, was a perfectionist. Not only in the songs, the parts, and the mixes, but also in the recording equipment and guitar gear that were used to make those Boston records that he either modified or invented. Flying over the top of those steady drum beats, groovy bass lines, keyboard wizardry, Tom Scholz Rockman guitars, and soaring solos, Brad Delp delivered some of the most famous and next-level vocals ever heard. Let's see how close to Tom Scholz and Brad Delp's perfectionism came to actually being perfect, and let's see if perfect sounds better or worse.
All right, you guys, this is really like watching the Mona Lisa being painted. This is a master at work here, Brad Delp. Okay, so what we have here, I've gone through and I've note detected Brad Delp's vocal in Cubase, which means basically I've taken these notes that he sang and I've tuned them. Here is Brad Delp untuned. And what you can see is these little blocks, these gray, white, they represent exact pitch. Like this note here represents an F. This note represents a D sharp. Let me play you Brad singing untuned, and then I'll play you the tuned version, and let's see what we think.
It's been such a long time. I think I should be going, yeah. And time doesn't wait for me. It keeps on.
Okay, while that's fresh in your head, here is the tuned version.
It's been such a long time. I think I should be going, yeah. The time doesn't wait for me. It keeps on rolling. It keeps on, keep.
I don't know what that note's supposed to be. I guess here.
It keeps on rolling, keep. It keeps on rolling. Sail on a distant highway, yeah. I've got to keep on chasing a dream. I've got to be on my way. Is there something I could say?
Here is the next phrase.
I'm just moving on. You'll forget about me after I've been gone. I don't want no more. It's just outside of your front door.
Okay, that's the untuned vocal. And we can see here.
Just outside of your front door.
Brad is dipping almost a half step below pitch. If the center of this was pitch, he's in the center here. Do we care? Have we ever cared? No.
Just outside of your front door.
Let's see if tuning makes that sound better if the pitch were perfect.
I don't want no more. It's just outside of your front door.
Your front door is definitely out of perfect tune here compared to perfect tuning.
It's outside of your front door. It's outside of your front door.
It sounds like a singer singing in 2021, not in the 70s. I don't like it. Let's see here what he does with the high note in the bridge. Good God. Unbelievable. I guess let's tune it up a little bit and see if we like it better. Look, it barely moved. It's not the Brad Delp I know and love, but it's fine, right? We love the old one better. Okay, so there's lots of background vocals down here with a lead vocal. Let's listen to Brad's tuned lead vocal with his untuned background vocals.
Well, I'm taking my time. I'm just moving on. Taking my time.
All right, now the untuned background vocals with the untuned lead vocal. My God, look how close he is to actually perfect. Unreal. Here we go.
I'm just moving on. Taking my time. Yeah, I'm just moving on. Taking my time. I'm just taking my time. Taking my time. Yeah. Taking my time. Oh, you know I want to get out.
Operating rooms, scrubs, and beard rental can be costly. Since starting this channel, we are $1.8 million in the hole. But you and only you can help us recover from this financial disaster. Please hit subscribe below. It's free, and it helps us and helps you to know when the next surgery is available to watch. Thank you for watching Music Surgery with Dr. Bob. I know. I shouldn't be messing with greatness. But rest assured, no files were harmed in the making of this video. Also, the purpose of this isn't a vocal tuning tutorial, but just to show how great these master singers sang with no help from a computer whatsoever. Times are different now, and the way we make records and the sound of music are different. Perhaps the true art of singing and playing will return someday to the radio waves like when the doctor was a kid. Until then, take care of yourselves and each other, and I'll see you the next time the doctor's in.
Let me show you two things quickly when playing the track that I didn't realize before. Let's listen to this part. That part. For all these years, I thought that was a guy hammering away on a bass that had distortion on it. Here's the bass part. What it is that confused me was some type of distorted clavinet. And I also didn't know that he had doubled the organ part with that clavinet. Amazing. All of these years, that has fooled my ear. Another part I want to play is right before the guitar solo. Here's the guitar solo. And this is really, this part especially is interesting arrangement-wise. Okay, we all know and love that guitar solo. Let me play this part with a guitar solo out. What? No distorted guitars underneath the guitar solo? Amazing. What you've got is the acoustic and the organ. Amazing. He cleared out all of the distorted guitars underneath the guitar solo, so the frequencies between the distorted guitars in the track and the distorted guitar solo didn't clash, which opens up the track to hear the guitar solo much clearer, with just an organ, acoustic guitars going, bass and drums.